Igor Gilitschenski wants to make autonomous driving a reality. The CSAIL Senior Postdoctoral Associate and his colleagues at the Toyota CSAIL Joint Research Center aim to further the development of autonomous vehicle technologies, reducing traffic casualties, and potentially even developing a vehicle incapable of getting into an accident. Surprisingly, research on autonomous driving has been around for a while. Research began in the 80s when the first groups in the US and Germany demonstrated autonomous road following without traffic. Even in these early days, self-driving car research had a strong link to AI and particularly machine learning. There are several misconceptions surrounding autonomous driving. Most people believe that there will be a fixed point in time at which self-driving vehicles will be introduced. In reality, it is more of an evolution than a revolution. It is already possible to drive autonomously in clearly constrained environments without traffic. More and more vehicles with autonomous capability have been deployed by companies on public roads and even make them available to the public. However, safe autonomy for all conditions that humans can navigate will probably still take a while. There are several major challenges on the horizon.
Right now, the biggest challenges involve making the vehicles more robust, particularly when interacting with others. This requires us to develop better models of other agents for prediction and a better understanding of difficult scenarios and rare events.
One focus of the group's work is to develop better simulation environments that allow them to generate a wide variety of different driving scenarios. They also focus on environments in which existing autonomous driving has failed.
For example, when driving in rural areas, there might not be enough distinctive environmental features, and we cannot rely on 3D models of the environments to perfectly know where the vehicle is. Instead, we have to look into approaches that do not rely on such models and centimeter localization therein to drive safely.
Another challenge is driving in extreme weather conditions, such as driving in snowstorms on roads that are completely covered. Such situations are challenging for most human drivers as well, and might require driving slower to avoid gliding and to avoid collisions when visibility is poor. The most visible difference to normal cars is due to the sensors that make autonomous driving possible.
Most AVs rely on 3D laser scanners, which are commonly mounted on the top of the vehicle. They are used to create high-resolution 3D models of the environment and to localize in these models. On research vehicles, you will also see GPS antennas. Unlike the GPS in a smartphone, these systems use an additional base station that sends a correction signal and allows for much higher localization accuracy. Two other types of sensors involve cameras and radars. These sensor types are already available in most off-the-shelf vehicles. They are commonly used for safety features and advanced driver assistance systems. Our vehicle at MIT is controlled from a laptop. It has additional compute infrastructure in the back to interface with the car, and this allows us to flexibly modify its setup and carry out different experiments.
While there is still work to be done, MIT CSAIL researchers are collaborating on the hard challenges to make autonomous vehicles more robust and allow greater adoption of the technology down the road. Autonomous vehicles will change the way cities look, possibly eliminating expensive parking spaces, reducing the number of traffic lanes, and leading to new traffic laws.